In this lecture, what I want to talk about is how to handle a situation where you don't have the raw data, you don't have the complete data set, but you still want to figure out what the mean is, because there are going to be situations like we have here where you have a frequency distribution. It's a summary of the data, but not the data itself. This might happen, for example, when you're looking at a journal article. The article might give you this kind of frequency distribution summary, but the authors didn't publish the raw data, and you'd like to take this and get some idea of what the mean is. And we have a method that we can use to do that, and I want to be clear about what we're getting here. This method does not actually give you the exact mean of the data. What it is going to give us is an approximate value for the mean. It's going to give us a reasonably good approximation so that we can at least have some idea of where that value is going to lie. So the way I do this is I'm going to add a couple of columns. This column here for the class midpoints and another column here for this product. And the first two columns are just the two columns with the frequency distribution. I just copied them from the previous slide. So what we're going to do here is we're going to start by calculating the class midpoints. And you remember the class midpoints are just the halfway point between the minimum values and the maximum values. And to find those, all I'm going to do is average those two numbers. For example, for this first class, I'll do 41 plus 45 divided by 2, and that's going to give me 43 for the midpoint. Then for the next one, I'll do 46 plus 50 divided by 2, and that's going to give me 48. And if you keep doing that for all of these classes, you'll get 53, 58, and 63. Now, I want to stop for a second and have you take a look at these numbers. Notice what happened here, right? The difference between 43 and 48 is 5. The difference between 48 and 53 is 5. The difference here is 5. And the difference here is 5. You should always get that kind of pattern, all right? That's one thing I do. It's a quick way to check my results, make sure I didn't mess up the arithmetic on any of those individual classes. If I come out to the same number to the same difference, I can be pretty confident that I didn't make a mistake in there. All right, so what I'm going to do next is I'm going to take these class midpoints, the values from this column, and I'm going to multiply them by the frequencies. So for this first row, I'll do 12 times 43. That's 516. For the second column, 22 times 48 is 1,056. 38 times 53, that's 2,014. 14 times 58, that's 812. And last one, 5 times 63 is 315. All right, so now I'm almost done. I'm going to add up the frequencies, right? And this is going to give me 91. And I'm going to add up these products, and that's going to give me 4,713. So then what I'm going to do to get my approximation of the mean is I'm going to divide the number I got from the products by the sum of the frequencies, and that's going to give me 51.791. That's my approximate value for the mean. All right, so I want you to think for a minute about what we did here. You remember the formula for the mean when we have the data is the sum of the data values divided by the number of data values. And I actually know this bottom value here. I know the exact value. If you add up all of the frequencies, what these frequencies tell me is there's 12 numbers in the data between 41 and 45, 22 numbers between 46 and 50. So if I add all of these up, I get this n value. I know that n is exactly equal to 91. The value I can't get an exact value of is this sum without having the full data set. So that's what I'm doing over here is I'm using that average, this midpoint of the class. It's kind of an approximation. So if I say that's the approximate value of the data, of the values in this class, and I multiply that by the number of values, I get the total of all of the values between 41 and 45. Actually, I get an approximation of the total. So when I add all of these up down here, I get an approximate value for this sum. And that's the basis for this particular method. So what I have here on this slide is another data set, another example for us to work with. This time these are some fictional airplane takeoff delay times. So what I'd like you to do is pause the presentation, see if you can work through the process on your own. Then, you know, when you start it back up, we'll move on to the next slide. You can watch me work through it and compare my answer to yours. So what I've done here is I've worked this out the same way. I've added the same two new columns. And I'm going to calculate these class midpoints. This one is going to be 1 plus 5 divided by 2. That's 3. Here I have 6 plus 10 divided by 2. That's 8. 11 plus 15 divided by 2. That's 13. For the next one, I get 18. And the last one is 23. You can do your quick check here. Each one of these is 5 more than the one before it. So I'm pretty comfortable I got that part right. Now I'm going to multiply across the rows here. 7 times 3 is 21. 5 times 8 is 40. 2 times 13 is 26. 0 times 18 is 0. That's okay. And 2 times 23 is 46. So when you add the frequencies, this comes out to 16. When you add the products here, this comes out to 133. So my approximate value for the mean is going to be 133 divided by 16, which is 8.313. All right, so what I want to do next here is I want to switch over to Microsoft Excel, and I want to show you how we can use Excel to do these calculations really quickly. All right, so you see I've loaded my data into the spreadsheet here, and I put the minimum and maximum values in their own row. All right, so for the class midpoints, I'm going to take the minimum plus the maximum and divide that by 2. Then I'm going to take that formula and copy it down. And that's going to give me all of those midpoints. Then for the products, I'm going to take the frequency times the midpoint, and I'm going to copy that value down. And now I have all the products. All right, I'm going to put a little formatting in here. Then I'm going to add up the frequencies, and I'm going to add up the products. And then to get my approximate value for the average, I'm going to take the product, and I'm going to divide it, the sum of the products, and I'm going to divide that by the sum of the frequencies. And you come up with the same value we got on the previous slide. So that's a really quick way to do this, right? It avoids a lot of those manual hand calculations. I don't think this method is particularly difficult. It's just that there's a lot of little steps. There's a lot of individual calculations you need to be done, and that always opens up a lot of opportunities to make, you know, a simple mistake on one calculation, and that's going to mess up everything from then on, including your final results. So if you can do this in Excel, I like doing this in Excel because you do the formula, and it's a lot of copying and pasting, and it avoids a lot of that really kind of messy manual calculation.